Well, it is an epic story from heartbreak to triumph, from sadness to success, and it is a story about how an active basketball player becomes a walking miracle in himself. A legend for so many reasons. Now here with us to share his epic comeback story is none other than the Teniente himself, L.A. Tenorio. L.A., welcome back to the show.
Yes, thank you. Thank you again for having me here sa bagong setup natin. Ganda, oh.
Parang mural niya, eh. Diba? Oh,
last time na pinaunlakan mo yung The Game, dun tayo sa bahay mo, sa couch mo. Oh. Yeah. Ngayon dito ka naman sa couch namin.
So may purpose pala talaga kung bakit ako ba. Continuation kasi.
Oh. And you know, speaking about that, syempre, the last time we got to talk to you were on the road to recovery going back to the PBA. But before we deal with yung journey mo, how are you muna? Mentally, physically, spiritually, ang dami mong pinagdaanan.
Oh, himay-himayin natin.
Oh. Himay-himayin natin. Oh, sige, isa-isayin natin. May oras ba tayo?
Meron!
No, actually, overall, I'm okay. Mm-hmm. I'm really okay, no? Actually, naka limang games na ako. And every day, feeling ko naman getting better. No? Actually, my goal really is to, you know, coming into this, you know, this series or this conference. Talagang target ko talaga is parang yun nga mga makapaglaro ako ng maayos during kung you know during this playoff na darating, no? So hopefully, you know, actually dito sa part ng career ko ngayon na actually yun na lang talaga yung inaabol ko, yung playoff, di ba?
Yeah.
Sana so what I'm doing right now actually when I started playing is really for me to prepare again for this coming playoffs. Hopefully, yun nga, makatulong pa rin ako sa team. Mm-hmm. So, yun yung goal ko. But overall, I'm totally fine as far as I know, sa katawang ko. I'm back. No? Nagagawa ko na yung the usual na ginagawa ko before.
Mm-hmm. Meron bang treatments that you are undergoing still? And while this is ongoing, while you're now playing, meron ka pang pinagdadaanan na ganyan?
So far, wala naman akong mga maintenance meds. Mm-hmm. No?
Yeah.
It's really normal.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Like before. But I still have, kasi nasa 1 year span pa ako ng what happened sa akin before. No?
Parang observation year. Period.
Observation period pa lang to. So part of that 1 year is every 3 months. Check up.
Yeah. Right, no?
So I have to go to my doctor and have check up every 3 months.
So may mga kailangan ka bang iwasan? May kailangan ka bang mas kailangan gawin? Ano ba? What are the... Well, wala kang maintenance meds, but how are you maintaining yourself?
Actually, honestly, sabi ng doctor ko, wala naman talagang bawal. Just have to be, everything's moderate, no? Mm-hmm. But of course, after what happened to me, ako, I decided, me and my wife, decided to, you know, somehow, change of diet, change of lifestyle. Somehow, everything's moderate, no? Mm-hmm. And kung ano yung kailangan iwasan, hanggat maaari, iwasan. Mm-hmm. But, kasi sa lahat ng nababasa namin before, just para maging healthy ka and everything, kung ano yung mga kailangan kainin o yung mga hindi dapat kainin. I've been doing that for the past how many years already.
I'm sure.
Kaya nga Iron Man ka, di ba?
So, ano lang talaga. So, hindi ko ngayon alam ko ano ba? Tama ba yun or mali ba yun because of what happened. But no, binalik ko pa rin yung dati. And, you know, honestly, I feel better physically.
Yeah.
I feel better now compared to to the past years. No, although I'm much younger
of course
years. But you know, with my age right now, parang I feel better pa rin.
Parang nasa optimal.
Yung pa rin eh. Kasi it's a big, siguro sa akin din, no? It's a blessing also. Diba, siyempre, ayoko rin nung nangyari sa akin. But, you know, looking at the brighter side, parang it turns out to be a blessing pa rin. Kasi nagkaroon ako ng parang, oops, teka muna, stop over muna tayo, and then recharge ka. And then now, I feel 5 years younger.
How big was it, yung return to basketball mo, especially mentally, emotionally? Because it's one thing to be, okay, medyo normal na physically speaking. Eh. Pero yung nung nakabalik ka, how much did that actually help you recover?
Actually, ang pinaka-importante talaga doon is mental. Tama ka. Mm-hmm. It's really mental. Kasi what happened to me is it wasn't easy, no? And then me deciding to go back to basketball, you know, very physical, very, mm-hmm. alam mo yun, yung ginagawa namin talagang on a professional level, medyo mahirap talaga. So yeah. Mentally, I have to be more tough compared before. Kasi dami ko na iniisip eh, na siyempre, I was out 8 months and then I have to recover. Mm-hmm. And then now, I have to recover for basketball and then get back on the rhythm, di ba? And I'm not, kumbaga parang, kasi I decided to go back to basketball, not just for the sake of going back to basketball. No, I told this to coach also, no, to coach team na, no, pag bumalik ako, gusto ko bumalik ako.
Yeah. Yeah,
I mean, probably it's not gonna be the same me compared last time, but somehow yung dedication, yung passion nandun pa rin sa basketball, no. So mentally it was tough, no, but syempre siguro na ano ko na din yan eh, na ready ko na rin yung sarili ko for the past how many years na rin naglalaro ako. And for me, I always look back at parang what happened to me nga 8 months ago, nalampasan ko, what more itong,
right,
you know,
right,
hard practices,
yeah,
twice a day practices.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah, I know. Yeah, oh.
In the middle of season, nag-second, like twice a day pa kami. So, di ba, parang ano lang eh, it's a matter of me just being grateful na, you know, na I'm here again.
Right.
You
know? Yeah. Yun, pag-usapan natin yan, bago natin pag-usapan yung laro mismo, no?
Yeah, yeah.
The comeback day. Yung practices, which your dad is involved in.
Yeah, yeah.
What was the first practice like being back with Ginebra after the Asian Games and all of these things? Kwento mo sa amin mabilis.
It was very fun practice. Uh-huh. No, everyone was very happy,
okay.
Excited. You know,
binibaby ka ba, brother?
Well, medyo, ano eh. Medyo parang, whoop, fragile. Parang ganun eh. Actually, ganun yung ano sa akin, yung treatment sa akin before during my first week of practices, no? And then actually after yun ba yung nakabalik ako, the week, 1 week warm up kami, and then the second week nag-training camp kami.
Yeah
we were inspired. Alam ba, so we had a training camp, so 3 times a day, basically 3 times a day practice with workout in the middle. So parang I was thinking na kaya ko ba to? Malalampasan ko ba to? So, but true enough, no, with the help of my trainers, or coaching staff and players, talagang ginaid talaga, tinutulungan nila ako. Mm. So, sobrang funny lang kasi nagkaroon sila ng parang fragile. You okay? Matamala ko. Kuya, okay ka ba? Nakakatawa eh.
Yun ang ini-imagine ko, pwede ka bang sikuhin
ako. Ano ba? Medyo fragile ako yung una. Pero I told them, eventually, sabi ko, I'll be better, I'll get better. No, ang hirap. Defensive slides, ang hirap. Sobrang hirap ng adjustment talaga. Parang gumalaw ng legs. Pero now, I feel really better now. And ngayon, pwede na talaga ang normal. Oh, pwede na akong saktan.
Hard foul, okay na.
Hard foul, okay na.
Alright, sige. LA, stay there. We're not done with you yet. We have a lot more to talk about.
Alright, we've got more on LA's return to the PBA after the break. So stay tuned. You're watching The Game.
How much do we love Pinoy sports? With all our heart, all the time. Download Pilipinas Live now.